Then Jesus said to the crowds and to his disciples, "The scribes and the Pharisees sit on Moses' seat. Therefore, do whatever they teach you and follow it. But do not do as they do, for they do not practice what they preach. They tie up heavy burdens hard to bear and lay them on the shoulders of others. But they themselves are unwilling to lift a finger to move them. They do all their deeds to be seen by others, for they make their phylacteries broad and their fringes long. They love to have the places of honor at banquets and the best seats in the synagogues and to be greeted with respect in the marketplaces and to have people call them rabbi. But you are not to be called rabbi, for you have one teacher, and you are all brothers and sisters. And call no one your father on earth, for you have one father, the one in heaven. Nor are you to be called instructors, for you have one instructor, the Messiah. The greatest among you will be your servant. All who exalt themselves will be humbled, and all who humble themselves will be exalted."
May have heard the term, "Oh, that boy is so full of himself, somebody needs to bring him down a notch or two." Well, that's pretty much what Jesus did when he spoke to the Pharisees in Matthew 23. A lot of people are really interested in the words of Jesus, the red letter editions. So if you have a Bible that has a red letter edition, these are actually the words that Jesus spoke to the scribes and Pharisees when he brought them down a notch or two. He doesn't immediately just start talking about how terrible they are. He actually begins by acknowledging that they carry a certain level of legitimate authority. They sit, metaphorically speaking, on the seat of Moses. And he doesn't tell the people to rebel against the leaders either, but he warns Israel not to imitate their hypocrisy. And then he begins this systematic takedown of their heart motives and their spiritual blindness. You know, the Pharisees were so high-minded and haughty, and Christ just begins to condemn them for how they behave because they do everything for the wrong reasons. Their motive is not sincere. They are not humble. They do things to be seen and approved by others. Jesus says these religious leaders live to be noticed, respected, and praised. They show off by making their wearable articles of worship ostentatious. I like that word. They're just show-offs. They just want to be seen. They want the most prestigious seats at the feast and in the temple. They love to be called by their official titles in the marketplace. But Jesus bluntly condemns their attitudes and tells his followers not to make the same mistakes. He uses the word woe, 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 woe to these people. And we won't go into the woes, but he pretty much just uses that word. And I can just see him saying woe as in shaking his head. Oh, this is bad. Don't do these things. Don't be like the Pharisees. And we can all seek to be, what about me? What about me? But Jesus really teaches us to be humble and to follow him.
Come, my way, my truth, my life. Such a way as gives us breath, such a truth as ends all strife, and such a life as killeth death. Come, my light, my feast, my strength. Such a light as shows a feast, such a feast as mends in length, such a strength as makes his guest. Come, my joy, my love, my heart. Such a joy as none can move, such a love as none can part. such a heart as joys in love. Amen.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.